Hi friends, hope everyone's doing well. This side Tanvi with you today. And today we will learn about the ohmic losses in solar PV system and how to determine the loss in Pvsyst. To simplify the discussion, we have segmented the session into two sub-sessions. In this session, we will discuss about DC ohmic losses. And in the part 2, we will show you how to assign AC ohmic losses into Pvsyst. Please watch other videos in this series as well to have a complete idea on PV system loss. And for the new viewer who are here for the first time, please hit the subscribe and like button. We will keep bringing such useful and resourceful content to you every week. So please subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified. After you open the detail loss window, the second tab in this window is ohmic loss section. Under this tab, the first top subsection is dedicated for solar panels DC wire loss. As you can see here, by default, the second option is already selected. In fact, it is always wise to put losses in percentage rather than the absolute value. By default, the DC ohmic loss here is 1.5%. In practice, the DC loss always lie within 2%. And it is not desirable to design a system with DC loss at more than 2%. Anyways, we will show two cases and methods to assign the DC losses in Pvsyst. In the first case, when you are designing the system for the first time and you don't have the proper array layout, then it's very difficult to quantify the actual DC strings and cable length. In such cases, you may consider 1.5% as standard DC ohmic loss. This is not too aggressive and not too conservative assumption. And if you know that in your project DC cable length is going to moderately high due to space constraint, then go for 2% DC loss and keep the DC voltage drop at 0.7 volts. This is very standard and safe approach. In most of the cases, this comes out to be accurate. But still, we are not recommending it. We are sharing our views and experience only with you guys. The second method is detail analysis. So, for that, you need to click on the detailed computation as shown here in your Pvsyst window. As you click on it, in this window, you will see a lot of options and parameters for detailed DC cable loss calculation. Let's cover all these one by one. First, on the left side, you can change the cable types. By default, it is 2.5 square millimeter. Usually, we use 6 square millimeter cables for DC strings. So, we will set it to 6 square millimeter. And we know the length of the cable here. So, we put the value of it as well. You can also choose the material type of the cable from the wire option. In the wire tab, as you can see, from 2.5 square millimeter to 300 square millimeter, all possible type of cables are there. And the corresponding maximum current carrying capacity and resistance values are also there. On the right side, you can select between copper and aluminum as material type. Also the resistivity value, look into the cable datasheet provided by the manufacturer for more details. You can also put the price details. We leave this pricing part as it is for now. Close this window, and back in the detail computation part, the second line on the left is for combiner box to inverter. So, if you are using a string inverters, then usually you don't need a DC string combiner box. You can directly connect the strings into the string inverter. Or if you are designing a large plant with central inverter, then you need a DC string combiner box. Here, we are designing a 12 MW solar plant with 2 MW central inverters. So, we put the average length of cables for each circuit, starting from DC combiner box to the inverter, and select the suitable cable size. We are selecting 240 square millimeter cable. And the type is aluminum. Also, to understand the cable arrangement, Pvsyst provides the schematic view option. By clicking here, the actual cable arrangement can be seen. You can see here the number of inverters and the strings per inverters. Strings are connected in parallel to the combiner box by default. Another interesting point here, on the left bottom section, if you check group of parallel strings, then the schematic changes here. This kind of arrangement is required when you are designing 100 MW or higher size of plants, where the inverter is large in capacity of say 3 MW or higher. And to minimize the DC loss, you plan to use pre-combiner box to reduce the power loss with higher cable size. Now click on the parameter option. Check here if everything is okay as per your plant array layout and your design estimation, and then click OK to save the design. Hope you get in-depth idea of DC ohmic loss in solar PV system and how to calculate DC ohmic loss in Pvsyst according to your system design. Our next session will be on the AC ohmic loss in Pvsyst. So keep subscribed and enjoy the learning process. Do not forget to like, comment and share this session. To follow our channel Minutes to Energy on YouTube and Instagram for more upcoming and interesting videos on solar PV system. Like how to start a solar business, how to design solar PV system and solar panel manufacturing process. Thanks for watching. See you in the next session.